So the thing that I love about the Surface Pro 7 is the speakers again. The speakers are front facing, so you're always directed towards it and the sound towards you. Unlike other tablets where the sound speakers are at the bottom or in the rear, since the speakers are facing towards you, you get this real crystal clear quality of sound.
Cooper, we are lined up.
Initiating spin.
It's also good for watching movies. The bass is a little bit low, but then the performance is really amazing. It does not feel irritating like some low quality speaker. The audio quality is really amazing. You really don't need a earphone, etc. It also has two microphones in the front, which means they are working together so as to nullify some outside noise. So the sound in your microphone is absolutely clear. With the Surface Pro 7, you really do not need a separate microphone for your video interviews or video conferences. The Surface Pro 7 gives you an advantage of expanding your memory storage. With the Surface Pro 7, you get a memory card, a micro SD slot, which can be expanded up to 256 gigabytes. Really cool, ain't it? Because for devices that are expensive, depending only on the internal memory can be frustrating, especially when you're using it as a tablet as well as a computer. You definitely need expandable storage. So this is a real advantage again. You can have multiple cards, you can easily swap them since they are physically outside and they are just a push away. You can easily swap memory cards and expand your memory. Another plus about the Surface Pro 7 is that the charger is a magnetic latch, which means you don't get to accidentally push your Surface Pro 7 when connected to a charger. At the same time, you also have a USB-C. You can also charge your Surface Pro 7 with an USB-C, but unfortunately it's not Thunderbolt, but then it's okay for a device of this type. You are not going to connect an external graphics card with the Surface Pro 7 and play games. I don't think any gamer who is serious would purchase small devices and compact devices like this for gaming. The feature that I like the most is how comfortable it is and the compatibility of the Surface Pro 7. You could literally take it anywhere you want. The kickstand is an amazing feat of engineering. It goes all the way back, and the Surface Pro 7 can lay flat for all your drawing experiences. How cool is that? And you can even put your load on this kickstand. This is a cool feat of engineering and it is built to last. It does not look cheap or like some low-class piece of engineering. I can use my Surface Pro 7 in any position I want. I can travel with it, I can use it in my car, I can use it when I'm lying in my bed. Everything is removable. You can remove your pen and then the keyboard is easy to remove. It's just a pull away. And then you're good to go in your tablet mode. I could just keep all day long reading my books, and then when I want to work with my keyboard or do some video editing, I can pull my Surface Pro's kickstand, connect it to the keyboard, and we are good to go. How handy is that? When it comes to laptop, which people want it to be compact, there is one major issue. It is heating. Fortunately, with the Surface Pro 7, the cooling system is amazing. There are vents all over the top. This device doesn't even come with an inbuilt fan, but still, it manages to remain extremely cool. There's no overheating, even when you use the highest performing apps like Premiere Pro or video editing applications. There is mild heat generation near the processor, which is unavoidable. Even with the devices with the most efficient fans, they radiate a little amount of heat. That is physics, that is unavoidable, but then you don't have that issue, especially if you want to put it on your lap. The keyboard rests on your lap, not the surface of the Surface Pro 7, which means the heat over here will not be in contact with your body. Another thing I love about the Surface Pro 7 is its rapid fast booting and shutdown process. Now I'll be showing you how fast it takes to shut down and restart the Surface Pro 7. You also have a sleep function, which means you can use it just like your mobile phone's lock screen. If you're going to unlock it, your device is ready to use and then you can lock it. Do you think it is going to drain your battery life? Microsoft has put very intelligent algorithms into it that it takes and manages the battery life very efficiently. It doesn't even get warm when it is in sleep mode inside your laptop bag. But let me show you how fast the booting and restart process takes place. As I said before, another thing is the hard disk in the Surface Pro 7. It is an extremely well-performing hard disk. It has got read speeds of up to 1000 Mbps and write speeds of about 400 Mbps, which I've tested it myself and it is amazing. This is what helps the Surface Pro 7 in booting real fast and loading apps very efficiently. Another thing most of you might have doubts on, who should get a Surface Pro 7? Is it good for gamers? Well, this is the i5 version of the Surface Pro 7. I will not say that it is not suitable for gaming, but then if you're going to play a few games occasionally with a little bit of lower graphics, then this will be a good device. But then the purpose of the Surface Pro 7 in the i5 version is not gaming. This device, it does not have a fan, so I would suggest to go for the i7 version, which has a fan inside. That would be suitable for gaming. But if you're really planning for getting a gaming, I would suggest you to go with Asus or Acer. They have monstrous gaming machines in the same budget. So a Surface Pro 7, especially this one, is very good for creators, book readers, content creators, and who use devices on the run. If you're traveling a lot, you're studying, you're a student, you create a lot of videos. I myself use this for creating videos. I'm with Premiere Pro all the time. I use most of Adobe's products and it's just fine. Of course, the encoding time is going to take a while, but then there's no lag while you're using the software. If you're waiting for something to be exported, you can leave it for a while. But if there is lag when you're performing activities, then that is a problem. Fortunately, this device is very good at performance. Now let's talk about the cameras. It has a front and a rear-facing camera. Since it has a rear-facing camera, it's a really good advantage. You can also use it to shoot photos and scan your documents. You could take photocopies of documents when you're on the move. If you're in a conference with notes everywhere, you could just snap photos of it. So it is a really useful. It is an 8-megapixel camera. It can also record videos at 1080p. It's the same with the front camera. It has a 5-megapixel front camera and it can shoot 1080p HD videos also. Hi guys, this video is being recorded with the Surface Pro 7's front camera and with the dedicated microphone. Hi guys, this is the video with the rear camera and the microphone of the Surface Pro 7. Let's talk about the battery life on this device. With such a compact device, which can do everything that a laptop can do, as well as a tablet can do, what do you guess would be the battery life? In real life, I've been using it and I'm able to get around 8 to 9 hours of battery life with medium paced jobs, just the usual activities that everyone does. If I'm using some hardcore activities with graphics, video editing, then it's going to be around 5 to 6 hours. So this is really an amazing ability for the Surface Pro 7's battery life. This is a good feature that Microsoft has done, especially with such a slim and a weightless device. The amount of battery and the usage time it gives you is really amazing. The display is also really good. It is a 267 ppi display. Since it is a huge display, it gives you a beautiful image quality. Unlike other laptop displays, this cannot be compared to them because it is way better than those laptop displays. This feels like a mobile display, especially when you're using touch input and your Surface Pen inputs. The response is really good and quick. It's very crisp and the way the Surface Pen glides on the surface is really flawless. Considering hardware, it has an ambient light sensor, which means the display's lighting adapts to your environment. So if you're in a darker room, you know what it means. And then it is a magnetometer, a gyroscope, and an accelerometer. These are all the hardware that you need for your applications when you're using it in your tablet mode. So that is very useful and very thoughtful of Microsoft to include these hardwares in the Surface Pro 7. Let's talk about applications. When you're using this as a tablet, you will definitely feel that the apps are less, because most of the apps are not there in the Microsoft Store. But then if you're using it as a computer, every software is going to be working in it. With Windows, you have backward compatibility. Even softwares which are decades old are going to work on these platforms. That is the kind of support that Microsoft provides us. But in case of marketplace apps which you use in your mobile phones, we really can't put the blame on Microsoft. For instance, Google refuses to make apps, YouTube apps, to Microsoft. Even when Microsoft came out with a third-party YouTube app, they blocked their servers and didn't allow Microsoft. Do you consider this healthy competition? Leave them in your comments below what you think about Google and how are they competing with other companies. I would be glad to hear about it. But Microsoft has other techniques. They have converted the Edge browser into a really impressive space. They have YouTube apps integrated in the Edge browser. You can convert any page into an app-like experience. That is what Microsoft has done with the Edge browser. If you're using a Google Chrome, I advise you to download the latest version of Edge browser, and I bet you're going to love it. Surface is a great device to take notes, and that is what is very impressive. This is a very helpful device for students, especially when you have a pen and a keyboard that are handy. The keyboard feel is amazing. The key travel is really good, and I've never used a better keyboard like this before. Not even the mechanical keyboards give you that greater feel that the Microsoft's keypad gives you. The touchpad is also good, but then it misses on haptic feedback. You have to have physical clicks on the device to be able to click. But then that is okay, Microsoft is going to come with the haptic feedback soon.